All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it coming to you live from the Oregon coast. It is a beautiful Sunday. Got the NFL football on. Things are nice, and we are ready for a beautiful, beautiful time of the tradition of college football, which is the heart of the schedule, the meat of the lineup. And again, we look forward to Thanksgiving at the end of this month now. We're basically, it's Halloween, happy Halloween weekend if you're into that sort of stuff. But we're getting at that position right in the schedule. It's a real sweet spot. I absolutely love this time where you know who these teams are. You're about halfway through the year. You've seen everybody for the most part. You're cruising right through it. Now you're stretching toward that home stretch. Now you can kind of see the finish line. And you can kind of start to make your plans almost for where do you think your team's going to be. So let's go ahead and get into it. I love this video. This is the Pac-12 video. If you guys are interested in joining any other chats, I do it on Tuesday night. If you guys want to get a hold of me, just send me a message, sports.chat.503@gmail.com, or send me a message on Twitter, Instagram. You can find me there, sportschat503. Let's go ahead and get into it. We have a huge opportunity to have a showcase game on a Thursday night. And again, Thursday night football, Friday night football is going to become more of the norm as we scratch and pull at this TV deal. There's huge news about the Big 12 TV deal, so just that's plenty of stuff to talk about in the future. But these Thursday night games are going to come, and so you have a big one. You have Utah up at the Palouse. It's a very tough game for Utah to play on the road up there. They have basically everybody out in their starting lineup. They lose Kincaid halfway through the game, and you know, this is just a really tough situation. What do? They just keep grinding, make itself through it, and they get the dub. And so you got to respect a team like that. You got to respect a guy like Whittingham who continues to have that kind of program that is going to just punch you in the mouth. They're going to dictate the terms. They're going to flip the script, and they're going to make you play their brand or their type of football. And I just love that because that's what good football teams do. Washington State, on the other hand, kind of cooped it. I thought they pretty much had a chance to win this thing. They just really didn't put it down together at the end. They did score 10 in the fourth, just couldn't really get it done in the other quarters. And it's really they missed out on some opportunities. I watched every snap of this game. It was very fun, very entertaining game to watch. But you got to love Utah for just doing what Utah does and continuing to win. And they do still have everything in front of them, even with the one conference loss, even with the loss to Florida at the beginning of the year. Oregon Cal, we talked about this game on my other video. I'm doing now like a post-game shows when we're on the road. I'm trying to do as much as we can here. I'm getting a lot of requests to do more and more, so I'm trying to fill it up. The Oregon Cal game was a great game. I think it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball. A lot of people don't like those, but I thought it was very entertaining. I thought a good football game broke out. There were plays we made on both sides. There were interceptions on both sides. I thought both defenses played pretty well, and I thought, you know, if you're a Duck fan in the past and you've been to a lot of these games and you've seen the games down at Berkeley and you've seen games at Austin against Cal, then a 42-24 score should probably be all right with you. And it is for me. I think that's a game that the Ducks really showed up and they did what they needed to do. And they continued to score again. Their second quarter is their big quarter. And a lot of times that could be because their last drive of their first quarter, they don't score. They score right away in the second quarter, which they've done a couple times this year. But I'm impressed with Oregon. I'm impressed with their offense. And they got a big game this next week. Because, again, these games that are kind of lower expectation games, man, games that you're supposed to win, these are games you got to get up for. You got to strap up the chin strap and get after it. And these become big games. I think good teams take every week very seriously, and every week opponent is a big week. You don't have to go cliche, every week's the Super Bowl kind of stuff, but you better gear it up because, again, you on any given day, weird stuff can happen. USC Arizona, man, I am really impressed with Arizona. I think they're ahead of schedule. I think they're recruiting well. I think they've got a good positive attitude. I think their coaching staff has really kind of changed the schedule that they've been on and kind of ramped it up a little bit, which I'm really impressed with. They just couldn't get it done against USC. You know, the USC just continues to score. The way they play in the second half is just really difficult. They put so much pressure on you offensively. Williams has 5 TDs. I mean, it's really hard to stop a team like that. And you know, if you're Arizona, you know, you're just thinking, hey, let's just try to get into this game. Let's stay in this game. Let's be respectful and respectable. And I think they were. I think they were right in this thing until the very end. It's a very fun game to watch. You got to respect USC. So this whole year, you know, when it comes to USC, UCLA, I thought that UCLA was going to have the edge. And it might have been a little bit of a hot take because everybody was leaning toward USC so much. But I thought this was going to be a big year for the Bruins, and I thought that they might have a chance to do this against Trojans late in the year, and I still do, but I'm leaning more toward 50-50, and games like this make me lean a little more toward USC. So we'll see how that goes in the future, but I expect them to win out and probably in that USC-UCLA matchup get the dub as well. Stanford-UCLA, they did what they needed to do. UCLA was kind of a snore after dark because, again, Pac-12 after dark, we're so excited for all this stuff that really is, you know, fireworks. Really no fireworks were popping last night, which is fine. But Stanford really just it was not great at all, and that is kind of a sinking ship, it feels like. It's a tough situation for them. But UCLA continues to roll, and again, that game against Trojans is going to be huge coming up on the 19th. And that's the same weekend as well that Oregon playing Utah, so it's going to be a showcase weekend for the Pac-12. Colorado-Arizona State, this was a wild one. I watched a lot of this one because Ducks are playing Colorado next week. I always like to try to watch next week's opponent for the Ducks. It also allows me to kind of watch everybody in the conference for the most part. And this is a game that, you know, Colorado actually played okay in. They you know, late in the game, you know, they were not getting blown out. But Arizona State just jumped on it early and had a pretty comfortable lead. They kind of just coasted, it felt like. But, you know, you got to give Arizona State some respect. You know, they're doing what they need to do. And it's impressive to see some of these teams that you thought was maybe in rock bottom, you know, kind of rebound a little bit. Now, I don't know who is really excited about that game because, in my opinion, those are the two worst teams in the conference. So it's a tough situation. And the way Cal played last night, I don't think you can compare Cal to those guys, even though Colorado did beat Cal. That's how the conference is. Again, that's how it works. Okay, we talked about these Thursday night and Friday night games. You're just going to get more of these, you know, with the idea of the Pac-12, what they can offer, what part of the schedule that they could, you know, possibly dominate in their market. And that's really the only one available because no one else is playing at that time except for the West Coast. And so you're going to have more of these, you know, so just get used to it in my mind. Thursday night games, Friday night games. Last week, obviously, had to have Utah, the returning champion, go on the road to Pullman to play on a Thursday night. I mean, your conference is not doing your champions any favors at all. In this case, this is a really fun game. This is an exciting game. I don't know if Friday night is really the best opportunity because there's not really that many eyeballs on it. I think Thursday night is better. Even with Thursday night football with the NFL, I think people can watch kind of two games simultaneously. But Friday night is a little bit of a tough one, you know, with high school football and everything else that people do. And if people do other stuff on Fridays, but whatever. That can be for another time. But we have a bunch of stuff to talk about this Big 12 media stuff, because now the Pac-10 is up, or Pac-12, whatever happens here going forward. We got to start talking about that sort of stuff a little bit. So Oregon State, Washington, one of my favorite games all year. Love this game. Absolutely. As a Duck, these are two of the more traditional rivalries that we have. And you got to love this game against the Huskies and the Beavs every year, no matter where it is. Now, this one's up at Husky Stadium. It's probably going to be rainy. It's probably going to be about 50 degrees. That's just how they do it up at Montlake, and that's how they like it. Now, the Beavs are ready to bring that chainsaw. Now, they just jumped into the top 25. It would be pure classic Beavs to lose this game because this is, again, you've worked so hard to get yourself to the top 25 your first week in, and then you go up to the Huskies and lose. This would be traditional Beavs Huskies football if the Huskies beat the Beavs, when the Beavs right now are in a better position than the Huskies are, even though they are in a situation where they're both 6-2, even though they're both 3-2 in league. I think the Beavs are trending upward a little bit now. I think the Huskies are as well, but people who maybe got a little high on the expectations of the Huskies early in the season, and seeing how, you know, Michigan State, for example, that big win, seeing how that's played out, other sort of stuff, how it's played out, the rest of the Husky schedule has given them maybe a little bit more question marks on the Dogs. I would love to see Oregon State win this game and continue to win. Now, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter to me as a Duck fan who wins this game, obviously, but I would like to see Oregon State and the Oregon game at the end of the year be a real big one. And it's going to be in the construction site. It's going to be weird. I think the Ducks can win that game, but I want that game to be as big as possible every year. And so this is a perfect opportunity where the Huskies could kind of ruin that by beating Oregon State this week, and then losing to Washington, losing to Oregon the next week. And that could definitely happen, right? They could split the Oregon schools very easily. I'm really impressed with Washington so far. You know, I was really hesitant because I really didn't know what they were going to get out of the new coaching staff, out of the transfer quarterback, out of some other sort of different situations that they were in, transitioning from one to the other. It bottomed out so bad during the Jimmy Lake thing that I didn't really know where they were going to go. So they're kind of in a situation almost like Arizona where, you know, you have to rebuild it. And Arizona being ahead of schedule, I think Washington's probably ahead of schedule. So this is a game that's a really quality game. I would like to see Oregon State lose, but I could definitely see the Huskies beating them. That would be absolutely on brand for the tradition of this conference. Oregon-Colorado is going to be a fun game. I'm going to be up there in Boulder. It's going to be a fun one. Hopefully the weather keeps checking out up there. It's been great in Boulder. And again, I think that that's always kind of the concern is what's the weather going to be like when you play late in the year in the mountain schools. And, you know, I think Oregon's just going to continue to roll. This is a game where Oregon's 7-1, Colorado's 1-7. I mean, this is a situation where, you know, it doesn't get much worse than this. You were pretty much the best team in the conference versus pretty much the worst team in the conference. So you should expect fireworks from the Oregon Ducks. And if you don't get them, maybe it's cause for concern. But at the same time, I think you're probably still going to beat these guys by about 40. Washington State, Stanford, you know, this is a weird one because Stanford feels like they're, again, punch drunk, on the ropes. Washington State needs a victory really bad. They've been very close. I expect Washington State to go down there and get the win. Again, as the conference works, would not be surprised at all if Stanford rallies and beats the Cougs in this one. But I expect Washington State to probably win by two touchdowns there because I just think Washington State's defense is very fast, very opportunistic. They'll probably get some turnovers. And I think the Washington State offense, if those guys play well, is one of the better offenses at times that we've seen so far, especially for the Ducks. I mean, again, I don't think they've played as good of a game that they played against the Ducks almost all year. So we'll see about Washington State. Arizona, Utah. You know, this is a big one because Utah at home is really tough. And Arizona is in no way, shape, or form capable, in my mind, of beating Utah up there consistently. But weird things happen. If the injury bug continues to bite Utah, if they don't heal up in the next week and they have to roll out the team that they played against the Cougs, and Arizona continues to play well the way that they played last week, I could see Arizona making this very interesting for Utah, and it's not a gimme at all. Whereas if you were to see earlier in the year, pencil this in, oh, it's number 12 Utah against Arizona, you're obviously thinking, you know, Utah 4-1 in the pack and Arizona 1-4, it's obviously going to be a blowout. I wouldn't say. I would say this is probably going to be tight. Unless those guys either one get healthy or two, those backups really gel this week and really have the green light, I think this could be a really close game. UCLA, Arizona, I still expect Utah to win though. UCLA, Arizona State, I should say. This is going to be a fun one in the desert. I think UCLA continues to roll. Arizona State does not impress me at all, but I'm really happy that they did rebound off their debacle when they fired their coaching staff and everything else, or fired Herm at least. And I just, you know, it's always tough in the middle of a season when that sort of stuff happens. So I'm proud of those guys that they were able to rebuild the thing and get some dubs on the way out of the game, or way out of the season. And they're going to put pressure on UCLA, but I don't think they're going to win. And then Cal USC. This is an obviously weird game because, you know, USC seems like they're a steamroller and Cal seems like they're really bad. Well, in the past, though, Cal's played fairly well. Cal's defense, I think, is up to the challenge at least to slow down USC. They just slowed down Oregon, and Oregon and USC are on a very similar path offensively this year. I expect Cal to make this interesting. I still think USC wins, but I expect Cal to make it at least interesting, slow them down a little bit. No, I expect USC to win. I think UCLA wins. I think Utah wins. I think Oregon State needs to win, obviously, to keep their momentum going. But I think Oregon wins. I think all those Pac-12 schools that are up there in that top 15 win. It's just whether or not the Beavs can hold that tight. Because, again, that's a tough matchup against Washington. Washington is another school that if the Huskies beat Oregon State, I wouldn't be surprised at all for them to be on that you know, second or third line of receiving votes for the top 25. So, all right, you guys, thank you guys so much for watching Sports Chat 503. Again, if you like rocking with us, check me out on that Tuesday night and join the chat. Just if you got a phone, it's very simple. StreamYard makes it very easy. I send you the link, you pop it on, you put your screen name on there, you're in. Say what you want to need to say, obviously within reason, right? But sports.chat.503@gmail.com. And then obviously, if you want to get a hold of me on Twitter or Instagram, I'm available on both of those, sportschat503. Let's go Ducks. Let's get into this thing, all right? Let's have some fun the rest of the year. All right, guys. Adios.